So hello, everyone. I'm a first-time presenter, and I'm happy to be here on the call today and to have the opportunity to show you my agent avatar sample. But before I start in the sample, I want to introduce myself a little bit. My name is Marc André Schröder-Zhou, and I live in Germany. On the slide, you can see some basic facts about my work experience. I've been working as a freelancer since 2011. And I do IT consulting in different fields. My passion is still developing applications as full stack developer, mainly with ASP.NET Core, Node.js, React, Azure. And another passion of mine is to introduce SharePoint in companies since 2001. Yeah, really it's 2001. And to help companies to get the full advantage of this wonderful and flexible product, especially in these days with SharePoint Online and Office 365. Besides this, I'm working as a lecturer for the university here in Frankfurt, and I'm teaching computer science. So, but that's all about me. Now let's start with the presentation topic for today. I had the idea for this demonstration because a customer asked me if it is possible to have an agent with more human characteristics and not only a simple chat window experience. Oh no, no Clippy. The customer wants a realistic person, not only a Clippy. I'm very sorry. Okay, anyway, I thought this was a very good question and I did some research about it, how this is possible. At first, I found the Azure Speech SDK and played with some samples that I discovered in the public GitHub repository. And at the same time, I wrote an article for a German IT magazine about Copilot and Microsoft Agent SDK. With the Microsoft Agent SDK, it is possible to embed the Copilot agent in different applications or on a website. I noticed that fits all good together because I need to embed the Copilot agent on a web page to access some events from the agent programmatically. For example, I need to know when the agent responds to a question. I'm going to show more details about this in the demo soon. Before I dive into the live example, I will give you an overview about the different pieces of the solution and how they work together, and a short explanation about what needs to be set up. So, of course, you need a Copilot agent. Unfortunately, my agent is grounded to my SharePoint Server 2010 book, and this is written in German. I'm gonna translate the response and questions during the demo later. So don't worry, you will understand everything. Then we need a special permission in order to embed the Copilot agent onto a page later. In this case, we need to extend the Entra application registration for the Copilot agent and add the Power Platform API permission. And of course, we need to set up a platform redirect for the login. As soon as the Copilot agent is prepared, we can use the Microsoft 365 Agent SDK to embed the agent to the page or on an application. As soon as the Copilot agent is prepared, and then after that, we can set up the cognitive services in the Azure AI Foundry. With the help of the Speech Service SDK, we can integrate the avatar into an application or on a web page. As soon as everything is implemented, it is possible to combine both the agent and the avatar SDK together. As you can see here on the slide now, the solution routes the answers and questions from the agent to the avatar. I showed it here in the picture. Then I use some events to detect when a question is sent to the Copilot agent and when an answer comes back from the agent. This sounds easy, of course, but to find the events was a challenge, and I solved it with a custom store, as you will see later. So that is a complete picture about all the SDKs that I use. And for the web chat component, we'll see for the rendering the Copilot, I use the web chat component, but I will show it later in the code. As I mentioned on the previous slide, you need to configure the authentication for the Copilot agent. The good thing is that every Copilot agent has normally an Entra application registration assigned. Here on the screenshot, you can see the relation between the agent and the Entra application registration. Just add the permission to the existing registration. So it's not necessary to manually create an Entra application registration. Another important aspect is the authentication setting for the agent. The settings controls the available channels for an agent. You can find all the details about the dependency in the documentation. I just want to mention it here. It's also very important that you check which authentication mode you need, and then you can check which channels do you have for your agent. So now let me show you the demo in action. I will open it and we will cross the fingers that everything works. I will refresh the page here. And hopefully you will hear my sound work. You can hear my sound also. This is a demo web page, and the connection with the Copilot agent has been established already because I logged in already to this page here. When I click to open the accordion, the magic starts. At this time, the connection to the Azure Cognitive Services will be built. So, ciao, you see the Copilot is loading. I have some debug message here at the end.
Hallo, ich bin ein Experte für SharePoint Server 2010 aus Entwicklersicht. Ich freue mich auf deine Fragen.
So, as you have noticed, I hope the agent sends a welcome message in the avatar, read it for us. Hopefully you heard it. Maybe you have some reaction. Is it?
We got it. Yep. Yeah. We heard it. Yeah. Yep.
Wonderful. It's in German. I'm sorry, but I can, I think you can understand it. So now I can enter my question in the chat window and send it to the agent. Please notice that the avatar also repeats my question. So I will just put a small message here. In German, was will translate it, but I think maybe everyone can understand it. So, what is an event receiver in SharePoint?
Vielen Dank für die Anfrage. Was ist ein Ereignisempfänger in SharePoint? Ich werde mich darum kümmern.
So, she told, thank you for your request, for your inquiry. Then she repeat my question, and then she said she will help us. She will find for some information about this topic. So now we have a little bit to wait. I hope not too long.
Ein Ereignisempfänger, Event Receiver, in SharePoint ist eine Komponente, die auf bestimmte Ereignisse innerhalb der SharePoint-Umgebung reagiert. Diese Ereignisse können beispielsweise...
So I will stop it here. I think you have already an understanding how it works. But one important point to consider is the integration of the video streaming for the avatar. Because
Hallo, ich bin ein Experte für SharePoint Server 2010 aus Entwicklersicht. Ich freue mich auf deine Fragen.
Starting again. Okay, wonderful. Okay, I will restart here. One important point to consider is the integration of the video here in the site because of the fact that the most browsers, I think all, don't allow you to start a video automatically before user interactions happens on a page. I needed to find a workaround. That's why I use the accordion open trigger event here. That's when I open the accordion to start the streaming. But after all, it makes sense not to start the avatar directly. A lazy loading is preferable in order to save cost, bandwidth. And that's why I would advise you to load the avatar only after a user request. Makes already sense. So this was the live demo for the solution. Let's dig into the code a little bit. I'm not showing all of the details, only the main interesting points. You can find the complete solution in my public GitHub repository, and then you can start to play with it. So I wanted to start with explanation how the embedding of the Copilot agent with the Microsoft Agent SDK works. So I switch to the studio. I have a zoom in here, so you can see everything. This is the HTML from the demo page as I showed you before, and the container for the agent is this web chat. The state is the ID web chat. The integration happens in the JavaScript file Copilot agent. I go to the Copilot agent. So that is asked for the first part to embed the Copilot agent, just the agent to the page. At first, I need to fetch an authentication token as usual. This happens here. I did this with a common implementation and use the Microsoft authentication library. This is this acquired token here. It's nothing special. An instance of the public client application is created. Go here, do it here. And in case there's no token available, a null token will be requested via the login pop-up. In my case, I was already signed in on the page, so we have no login prompt. Just notice the request for the special permission here. I need a special scope here, special permission, this api.powerplatform.com/.default. Then we go back to the Copilot agent. With the token, a new Copilot Student client instance is created. It's here, this part here. I use here the web chat component to add the Copilot onto the page. This is the easiest way to embed the Copilot on the page with the render web chat method here. The web chat component is part of the bot framework and is highly customizable for the communication a direct line connection is established. This is this line here. During the initialization, then we have the connection. And as I have explained in the slide already, I need to find an event to combine the Copilot agent with Avatar, because now we have the Copilot on the page, but we need to communicate also with Avatar. This relation is done with a custom store. Within the store, it is possible to modify store action. In my case, I use my own store to hook into the events from the agent. And my store implementation is this one here. You see, I create here a new store with create store from the web chat. And then I save my new store in the variable named store. This makes sense. And then I pass this variable here inside the method called render web chat. So I check for the action type. And this is the important thing. I check here the action type. In case the action type is direct line incoming activity, this is the first condition here. And the message type is message, and it comes from a bot, then I know that the response has been received. In case I send the response text to the avatar, this is when I send the text. In case the type is web chat slash send message, that's the other condition here, I know that a new request question is sent to the agent, and I can repeat the question. Here I add the text, many thanks for your question. The question will repeat it. You see here, I will put the original question inside the string, and then I add the text, I will try to find an answer. So then the user knows, okay, the agent is working, he is doing something for me. The concrete text is sent to the avatar with the method Windows speak. This is this call here in both if clauses. So let's go to the avatar implementation. The avatar implementation starts, or the initialization starts with the start session. And I have this here in the avatar speech. And one note for demo purpose, I have my keys here. In production, you should not embed the keys directly in the page, of course. Pull the keys from a backend when the user is authenticated, for example. And this is only for demo here, of course. So then at first I get my speech configuration with the method from subscription. This is this line here. Then I define the settings for the avatar within the new avatar configuration. This is this line here. I create a new configuration. And here it's possible to set the appearance of your desired avatar, for example, the avatar style and some characteristics. I will show the possible other settings later in the Azure ID Foundry playground. So I have to check the time. So my timer, okay. Then, as soon as all settings are prepared, I fetch the necessary keys via the get call here to this endpoint, region.ttts.speech.microsoft.com, and the other rest, I will not read everything. The endpoint is provided by the speech service. Via the endpoint, I get all information for the necessary ICE server. After the data arrived, I can set the remote ICE server. Because a real-time avatar uses the WebRTC protocol to stream a video, and this relies on an ICE server network relay. This is done here, this part. After that, we have a reliable peer-to-peer connection established. Then in line 161, a new instance of the avatar synthesizer is created from the speech SDK. I also attached here an event receiver, but only to log the messages that come back when he started to communicate. So then inside the web setup WebRTC, I go to the WebRTC on top. This is this one, the WebRTC method. Inside the WebRTC, the streaming are connected with the medium and audio player on the page. For the streaming, a new video and audio tag is here created dynamically. I did not change the method here and keep the most from the original sample, but I found for this avatar, just to note the property event.track.kind contained either the literal string video or audio. This is this line here. And in event track kind, we have either audio or video. And regarding the content, a HTML event is created and added to the HTML page via an append method. That's classic HTML JavaScript here. So I have also added a link to the Microsoft documentation where you can find a more detailed explanation about the WebRTC protocol to stream videos. So that's all from the code perspective. As I said, you find the solution by public GitHub. In case you just want to check out some settings and possibilities for the avatar, you can do it with the Azure Foundry Playground. I will go to the Playground for a shot, and you see this, you know this person because this is Lisa, this is standard avatar, and you have also here other avatars that you can test. Yeah, you can switch here to other avatars, and then you can here put some text, and when you go to play the sound.
Hello, I am an avatar. How do you do today?
And then you can test everything, and so you can also change the language. So interesting, you can play a long time with it when you like, maybe when you have here another country language with an accent, for example, India, then it sounds a little bit different.
Hello, I am an avatar. How do you do today?
So you can play with a lot of settings here. So I think that's everything for me. That's all for me. I go back to my slides to have a short recap. First, consider the authentication setting it needs for your agent. When you start to embed your agent on the page or in an application, then check the available agent channels. That is also important because the available channels are depends on the authentication settings. Then each Copilot agent has its own intra-app registration already in place. You can just use this and add your permission to the existing one. Keep in mind, video producing for the avatar is not for free. Of course, it costs computer power to generate the videos. Also, consider the region. Not all services everywhere available, so you have to check if the service available that I need in Azure Foundry. Test the settings in the Azure Foundry Playground. There are a lot of settings available. And possible scenarios here, for example, in HR portal, in SharePoint, in customer self-service portal, in product helper, or an online consulting service. So that's all from my side today. Hopefully it was helpful to someone. Thank you und auf Wiedersehen.